We are living in a society whereby our parents, my mom or my dad, is going to do work, 3 or 4 jobs, and the son finishes high school without a proper foundation, like Dr. Faith had said, and then they get lost in between. And it is very discouraging if you don't have to let your child go through whatever you went through. And Jen Irongo from Oklahoma just said, true, we need to build social and cultural capital. I don't know what your message is to the community leaders out there, the Kenyan community leaders, as far as inspiring and building a united front for our young people. When you speak about that, think about the issues of depression that has become rampant in the lives of our young people. Where are we going wrong as a society?
Okay, so I will tie the two in a minute, but let me also address our community leaders. And this goes back to something we call like assimilation to American culture. And as I mentioned before, when you go to Rome, you want to do like at least be compatible to that culture, because there are some things we did in Kenya, and the way we were raised in Kenya, that's not the way we are raised in families in this country. So, and parents and leaders of the community need to know the generation we are raising, it's not they are not going to follow the same footsteps that we followed. We were raised a different time, we are totally different generation with the generation we are raising. They are socialized to different things. They are exposed to different things. And whether we like it or not, we have to know what they are facing. And sometimes it takes the educator to be educated so you can be able to raise your children. It takes a lot of, like, for example, I'll start with the very young ones. Mm-hmm. So you come to this country and you're told, okay, you cannot spank your children. It's illegal, right? Yeah. What happens when you spank them and they go say you spanked them? Then you are in trouble with the law. But do you take time to educate yourself and to learn, like, okay, I spank my kids for discipline. So what are the ways, or how can I wrap all these discipline issues so that my kids can learn? Because by the end of the day, you want results. How do I get these results? So you be like, we do not spank. Then you do not know any other way to do it. You raise reckless kids. Then soon they will be actually be beating you because you did not have a plan on raising them. So you really have to educate yourself and know and parent, be dedicated. A child does not come with a manual, and not even a teenager. When they get to teenagehood, they will still need to be parented. So you have to keep learning, first of all, grounded in the word of God. And then also, how do I instill these values? How do I instill character? How do I make them become responsible? How do I help them know their identity while being compliant with what is dictated by this lad? Mm-hmm. How do I, if you go to school system, they say they don't mix church with state. How do my child uphold Christian? Don't forget, back in high school, we are in CU, we are in this and that. In fact, if you had some good identity when you are Christian, here if you are Christian, you keep your Bible, you don't mention scriptures, they will say you can say it like inspiration, but you cannot quote something, you cannot pray with a child. I have close friends that work in school system as counselors. And they share the struggles they go through because mm-hmm. they want to point kids to Jesus. They want to tell them there is hope. They want to pray for them. But sometimes you have to say prayers like a conversation so you do not get in prayer, so in trouble. So all that, if we are not careful and if we are not brought up to speed, then we get to a point and we start getting that generation gap. The culture confusion, because the kids that we are raising, we are not familiar with the culture here and things in this country, and they are not accepting what we are teaching them. In fact, you push your culture to them until they leave your doors and they will never come back. They leave it there. They hate it because it's kind of you force it. How do you teach it such way they appreciate it and they know their roots and where they came from? So as educators and as parents, that goes a long way. The other thing is sometimes our kids get into depression because they do not have friends in their parents, or you do not have a relationship, let me put it this way. Mm-hmm. So maybe growing up, your relationship with your parents was yes and no. In this generation, you cannot parent your kids that way. You have to have that relationship. You have to, especially in their formative years, mm-hmm. you want them to know they can talk to you, they can have conversations, you can, and these are the things you are teaching them. You're having like a dialogue, not just you dictating. So, and they are comfortable. So when they are teenagers, you don't push them away, or they do not go away because they never knew you as a friend. We live in a country whereby kids have a lot of extracurricular activities. Kids connect to through, are you going to their basketball game? Are you there for the after school program? Are you the dad, like us growing up, most dads were like, moms take care of the kids, dads provide, and you don't even see this provision that your dad used to give your mom the money and then your mom will get what you need. So technically he was not there, but he was there when you are growing up. You do not see the fact that he provided. You see a dad that was absent. Mm-hmm. In this nation, if you want to succeed raising your teenagers and your young adults and they do not end up in depression, you have to be present. You have to have a relationship with them. You have to know what their struggles are. They have to be comfortable that no matter what happens, even the very controversial things, because they hear it all. Sometimes they know so much than you do because they live here and you don't. You know, I see so many Kenyans, so many of us, we are so conversant with what goes on in Kenya. You know who is doing what? Shaba zinaibiwa wapi? All those, you are up to date. But if we ask you what goes on the US, your child knows US inside out. Mm-hmm. So we live in the same space, but your mind are in two different places. So they end up knowing more than you. Here, like we live in a nation where there is so much freedom of speech and freedom of everything. So the things that you are not proactive in teaching your kids, they learn it somewhere else. And unfortunately, they are even taught in the school system. Do you sit down with your child and deprive at the end of the day? What are they learning in school? Mm-hmm. So do you teach them like the appropriate and not appropriate behavior? So if something happens, they'll be able to come and talk to you. Do they feel safe when something happens? And we are talking of when they go to school, you see something that they'll be taught it's okay to feel like you can be in a boy's body, but you feel like a she. And somebody is going to put that in their head and tell them it's okay and provide them with the information. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you lock the screens in your home, but when they go to school, they have full access. How do you address that? How do you work with them so they can come to you not to be convicted or punished, but for guidance as they navigate their identity. So when that does not happen, then that's when they start going into depression. They do not have anybody to talk to. They're in trouble. They cannot talk to you. I don't know whichever state you're calling from, but if you are in the state of Washington, kids start talking of the legal staff. It's legal here, Captain. And they will come and they will tell you they don't do drugs except the legal staff. Mm-hmm. So some of us, sometimes you don't even know what your legal child staff, is yes. doing. It is out there. There's a place for prayer and there's a place for counseling and for talking to your child and for walking the walk with them. So before we get to that depression state, mm-hmm. where they are lonely, they do not have anybody to talk to, if we start seeing some issues like that, we need to seek help. If you come from where I came from, depression is a spiritual issue. You have some demons and we need to cast them out. Here, we treat it as a real illness. You are depressed. It's like somebody that have headache. You take Tylenol, it goes. You go through treatment, therapy, medication, you get a chance of getting better. It is okay to go seek for help if you are depressed. It is okay to accept, there are those, somebody will comfortably accept diabetes or high blood pressure, mm-hmm. but depression has a lot of stigma, especially with Africans, actually immigrants, let's put immigrants, because mm-hmm. we all associate and we want to make it spiritual, or you must have done something to be going through that path. I want to say this. It is okay to seek help. Get help for your teenagers. Get help to yourself. Captain, depression is just not getting our children. It's getting the grown-ups.
Yeah.
Life becomes so hard. You mm-hmm. are overwhelmed. You do not know where to turn to. And the next thing, you are losing it. But you cannot go talk to somebody. Sometimes it's unfortunate because all these come through our doors. And before you get to that feel that somebody is dealing with depression, mm-hmm. their body starts breaking down, they have pains everywhere, they have this and that, they are dizzy, whatnot, and then it takes so much and you go through around so many things before you can narrow it to depression. So it's not only for our teenagers and young adults, because they are not making it in life, it's also for the adults it's happening too. So it is okay to ask for help. The other thing, and then I'll hand it back to you because you mentioned this. We came here, we struggled. Mm. Our children, we want to provide them with everything. And just ask and it will be done. That's the kind of how we are raising our kids. When they are 5, 6, they have iPhones, they have iPads, they have all manner of INS. Anything they ask, daddy has it, mommy has it. So we do not teach them that responsibility that they can earn. You do not start instilling that nothing comes easy. So they are provided for. They know no struggles. They live in your house even after high school and after college. They don't pay bill. You pay their cell phone, you pay their car, you pay everything. Mm-hmm. So the moment you push them out of your doors, they do not know how to follow rules. They do not know how to take responsibility because everything was done for them. So what happens? They are fading out there because they were not taught how to deal with that. The next thing, they are depressed and they are committing suicide. Mm-hmm. So as much as we can afford, we want to start teaching kids responsibility as they grow. It's okay to earn a cell phone. Before I get a cell phone, you have to mow the yard, you have to bring garbage out a few times, and save and buy the phone. So Santa does not bring everything you need on Christmas. If you've mm-hmm. not earned it, you don't get it. So what do you do when they have that job they want so much? Mm-hmm. Let them pay a bill in the house. They live in the house. Let them pay the water bill. You're not doing that because you cannot afford and it's your child and you can do everything for them. You're doing that to teach them some responsibility. Let them fail in your eyes so you can correct them. Mm-hmm. Out there, if they are not meeting deadlines, they are getting fired. If they are showing up late to work, they are getting fired. And what does that tell them? I'm a failure. I have failed. So when you are bringing up your child, you want to see the future. You want to be, you know, like you are their other God. So you want to see them 5 years from now. Are they going to be somebody just sits on the couch every day? Your daughter will be somebody's wife. Your son will be somebody's husband. What kind of a husband are you raising your son to be? Are they the one that will come home and just sit and wait for the food to be ready? And you know that lazy louse one. So raise them to be somebody. And that is going to help us eliminate all these depression and struggles as they grow up, because they've had everything. And once you set them free, they do not know what to do. And they'll come back home.